Today on the BV3D channel, I'll show you how you can go from this to this with this one simple trick, right after, you guessed it, this. I'm Brian, and you are watching BV3D. Hello, 3D printing friends, and welcome back. Today on the BV3D channel, we'll learn how to improve the surface finish on a 3D print from one of these newer, faster printers, and talk about what you give up versus what you get. FDM 3D printers used to be super, super slow. But in the past couple of years, they've been getting faster and faster, and that's awesome. But there's a downside to all that speed, because sometimes speed kills the beautiful surface finish that some of your filaments are capable of. And here's an example. This fidget cube from designer LaForest Labs was sliced and printed at regular speed, which is fast, on a Bamboo Lab X1 Carbon. And this one was printed with the same filament on the same printer with one simple adjustment in the slicer. I think the result is a lot better. For this video, the filament I'm using is Protopasta HTPLA in this beautiful night before blue color. It has a nice dark blue with plenty of glittery sparkle. Yes, Protopasta can be expensive stuff, but I happen to like it, and so I want it to look its best. Hashtag not sponsored. So it's not just on Bamboo Lab printers where you'll see this effect. I noticed it when I printed this Battlement Dice Power from designer Clockspring on the speedy little clipper-based Ender 3 V3. The finish was dull, and that made me sad. And I've seen it happen with other filaments on other fast printers too. So when I used my X1 Carbon to print a fidget cube for my kid, I noticed the same thing, a dull finish when I expected a glossy, glittery one. Thinking back to some of the speed benchies I've printed, I've noticed that the slower parts of them are sometimes glossy while the faster parts have a dull, matte finish. And that was my clue. What I needed to do was slow down. So I reprinted the model and set the X1 to silent printing mode, which cuts the print speed in half. And that got me this result. To be honest, it looks almost the same. Like, it's a little better, but it seems that even at half speed, it's still printing too fast to get the best looking result. And of course, slowing the printer to half speed doubled the print time. That second print took 2 hours instead of a little over an hour for the first one. So then I said to myself, self, because that's what I call myself, I said, self, I need to print this even slower. And I don't care if the inside of the print looks shiny and glittery. I only care if the outside of it looks shiny and glittery. What would happen if I slowed the printer way down, but only on the outer skin of the print? So, in Bamboo Studio, I switched to the Speed tab and set the outer wall speed to 40 millimeters per second instead of the 200 millimeters per second it normally uses. If you're using Orca Slicer, the setting is in the same place. If you're using Prusa Slicer, it's in the Print Settings tab's speed category as External Perimeters. And if you're using Cura, it's in the Custom Settings panel. Search for Outer Wall Speed to filter out the other settings. Hey, if you're enjoying this video, a subscribe would really make my day. That lets me know I'm making content you enjoy and you want to see more like it. Thanks. So back in Bamboo Studio, when I sliced it with that speed reduction on the outer wall, I got a print time of an hour and a half. So it takes 50% longer to print because we're going so much slower on that outer wall. But take a look at this result. That's what this should look like. Nice and glossy and glittery. But this doesn't just apply to Protopasta filament. Anytime you're expecting a glossy or shiny finish, and you're getting a dull or matte finish, try slowing down that outer wall, or external perimeter, or whatever term your slicer uses to refer to the outermost skin of the print. Of course, sometimes you don't care about the surface finish, and you just want a print to get done as quickly as possible. But for those times you do care, remember, slow down fused filament speed on that outer wall. It'll cost you a bit of time, but the result is a better, result. So that's it. I just wanted to share that quick tip with you in case you run into the same kind of problem. It's one of those things that I knew, but then forgot, and maybe you knew it, but forgot it too, or maybe you're new to 3D printing and haven't really run into it yet, but now you'll know. Big thanks to everyone who supports the channel, whether with channel memberships or by using the links in the description. If you liked this episode, give it a thumbs up and maybe consider subscribing so you don't miss new ones. Well, 3D printing friends, that's about all the time we have for this one. And now that we're at the end, let's go print something cool.